have a China Aviation Lithium Battery that is 4S3P 240 mAh capacity, 12V DC. It is managed by a DALY battery management system for 4S 12V and a maximum discharge of 250 amps. In this video, I will install the Sinowealth battery management system software on my Windows 10 laptop. I will then connect the laptop to the DALY battery management system using a USB-to-UART communications cable. I will then run the Sinowealth software on the laptop and open the comms port to manage the settings in the DALY battery management system. So join me in this video as I show you how I do this. I have the Sinowealth BMS2 set up version 0.1 MSI on my laptop. I will click on it now to start the installation. Unfortunately, it's all in Chinese, but this means next, so I'll click on this. And you have to install it in the root directory, so just say next and next again. So it started the installation process. It should be finished very fast. Here is the software that's installed on the C drive, program files x86. So it's 32-bit software, Sinowealth folder, Sinowealth BMS. Click on Sinowealth BMS 2.0.1. There you go. I have not connected the DALY BMS, so that's why the initial error. After this, I'll connect the DALY BMS to this Sinowealth software via the USB to UART cable, and then continue from there to look at the data in the BMS. At the moment, without being connected to the BMS, you can see this is what the view looks like. I have now connected my Windows 10 laptop to the DALY battery management system using the USB to UART communications cable. So I will now start my Sinowealth battery management software tool. Click here. It brings up a dialog box. It says to select the IC number. I know that my IC number is SH39F003. So I select that. Everything else here is okay. You can't select any other COM port. Windows has chosen COM port 5. All the other communication settings are good. So open comms. It says open serial COM 5 successful. Click OK. And it brings up the actual Sinowealth battery management software tool version 0.1. There is no data because you have to scan all. So I will click on scan all. And this is where it pulls in data from the battery management system. It tells me cell voltages. So this is 4S3P. So cell 1, 2, 3, 4, those are the voltages. Total voltage 13.3 volt, that looks right. But click on MCU and then click on read all. It will tell me all the settings. So the settings are 10% voltage is equivalent to 2.75 volts for one cell. 50% capacity or state of charge is 3.15 volts per cell, and 100% SOC is 3.65 volts per cell. This is a 4S3P battery bank. It has 240 mAh capacity. You can change this. You can change it by clicking on it, full capacity charge. But I'm not going to because that's the correct setting. So you can change all these voltage capacity settings to what you want. But I won't. I'll leave it at factory default. I go to charge tab. I've set the charge over current to 125 amps because on the DALY BMS that's printed on the top plate to say it's 125 amps. For this charge, I've changed it to minus 250 amps because that's also printed on the top plate of the DALY BMS. Calibration tab. I'm not going to fool around with anything else. If I click on the calibrate tab, that's the window. If I click on the backup tab, that's the window. If a new firmware for the DALY battery management system has been released, and you've downloaded a copy of that and you want to upload the new firmware to your DALY BMS, then what I've done is created a document for myself so I've laid out the steps so I don't forget it. And the first step is you go to your options, you click on ISP. That will bring up a dialog box which says code load, E2 prom load, start update. Click on code load and it brings up a browser which allows you to go to the folder which contains the new firmware. In this case, this is the new firmware. Click open. After that, click start update. This button here. And you will see a progression bar moving from left to right which says code region updating. And when that firmware has been fully loaded into the DALY BMS hardware, and the message will say firmware update OK. And that's all you need to do. Well, I do hope you enjoyed this video and found the information helpful. Do hit the like button and subscribe to my channel for more and to help the channel grow. Thank you so much.
This is a cautionary warning for viewers of this video. I created this video to demonstrate how to connect the DALY battery management system to the Sinowealth PC software. It is strictly to demonstrate the process of using the Sinowealth software. It is not intended to instruct on the values to set for your own battery management system. To do that, you must seek instructions from the manufacturers of your specific brand and product of battery management system and batteries. Do not use the values in this video. If you do so, you will risk damaging your batteries, your battery management system, and any other equipment nearby.